Hello guys and girls, how's it going? And welcome back to some Valkyria Chronicles. Yes, I know, it's been probably about a year. Well, it's been since September last year, so it's been a while. As usual with Valkyria Chronicles updates, long time between them. I do enjoy this game a lot, but I don't play it much. But Valkyria Chronicles 4 is on sale at the moment, and I decided to pick it up, so I might be doing some videos on that soon. So last episode, if you do not remember, we lost Isara. We lost Isara. Huge loss to the team. Everybody was very upset. And yeah, now we're on to the fight for Bruhl. Let's get started, shall we?
Let's begin the strategy meeting. First off, I need to ask. Lieutenant, how is Squad 7's morale?
It's been 3 weeks since we lost Isara. We're all still in shock, Captain.
Doesn't matter about all the other squad mates we lost, but, you know, Isara was the main one, you know. She's the important anime girl.
Personally, it still doesn't seem real to me. I can't believe she's really gone.
I see. Nevertheless, you have new orders. I sent in a request to General Damon to allow this op, and received full clearance. The Galleon Militia's next task is to liberate a small border town called Bruhl.
Gasp.
The regiment will surround the area while your squad enters and secures the plaza. Any questions, Lieutenant?
No, Captain.
I'm taking temporary personal leave, but I wish you the best of luck out there.
Also, I'd like to introduce the new tank pilot assigned to the Edelweiss.
Who will it be?
I'll do the best I can, Welkin.
Kreese?
He recently volunteered to be a pilot. I'm hereby assigning him to Squad 7.
Isara inherited the Edelweiss from her father. I'd like to take over where she left off. I'm still nowhere near as skilled as she was, but I'll do my very best.
Thank you, Kreese.
You're not nearly as hot, but at least I'm not related to you.
That concludes our meeting. I look forward to good news from Bruhl. Dismissed.
Okie dokie. So we got ourselves a new Edelweiss pilot, and Kreese. So, Jaeger's reason, the fight for Bruhl. So I'm pretty sure Bruhl is actually the hometown.
Bowsen was lost, and Gregor with it, in a warrior's death.
I thought she meant thousands lost, as in like thousands of troops, and I'm like, that's not how you spell thousands.
What comes next, Maximilian? Things aren't looking very good these days.
The Empire claimed the earliest victories, and most of Gallia with them. Their struggles since have bested the detachments holding each location.
Meaning, we reconcentrate our forces?
Yes. Send word to gather our armies on the Nagyar Plain. Silvaria, the time has come to show these rubes your power.
Some rubes, eh? Let's go show these rubes. Let's scam out some money. It's 10 skiddy-doo. I don't imagine this amazing high prince saying rubes. I am just picturing The Simpsons right now, and just the carnies there just being like, damn, look, these guys got a proper house, it's got a door and everything.
Sir, by my Valkyrian blood, I swear the Gallian forces will bow before you.
Yeah. I believe it. They won't last long once you get serious. And that's good news for me and the prospects for Firald's reinstatement.
Once we conquer Gallia, you shall have independence for your homeland, Jaeger. But until then, you have no country of your own. You shall serve us with your very life.
So Jaeger is doing it to free his own country, so he's not just an evil villain.
I'm well aware, Your Grace. The fate of the Empire is no concern of mine. But Maximilian, you will be victorious. It's the only reason I'm fighting this war.
So we learn about our enemy and his deeper reasonings. So we'll continue on with the cutscenes. Power through this section. Yes, I could edit it and make it look all pretty, but...
We're back. Back to where it all started.
It's been 5 months since we left Bruhl. Now, all but one of us is back to make this home again.
Ellipses.
Captain Varad said she specifically requested this operation from General Damon.
She said that?
Yes. You know how she feels about him, but she begged him to give us Bruhl. She wanted us to remember why we're fighting. Must get past Isara's death.
Yes, Ellipses.
For right now, let's stop thinking and just move forward.
Let's not plan any attack, let's just charge in like fools and die.
Let's take back take back Isara's home.
Well, her home is now a pit in the middle of somewhere. There's some soil over the top of that, really, Welkin? Old buddy? Alrighty, so... onwards we go. Return to the temple.
Back again. I had to return one more time.
Valdio, what are you doing? Dum dum dum.
But the area we saw last time. No matter what I try, the door won't open anymore.
Have you tried knocking on it?
What was written on those walls turns all of Europa's history on its head. It's staggering. It began, "Welcome, Sister Valkyria." They hide the truth from all but their own. The door won't let me in. Given what's on the walls, maybe it opens only for the Valkyrie. Maximilian got through, but he had Salvaria with him. She must have opened it for him. Wait. The door was closed when we first arrived.
Gasp!
No, it's not. Chances of her. No, there's no other explanation.
Of course, it's her. I mean, she's the only living female protagonist we got now. Seeing Sara managed to get herself shot, and you know, like, sure, we've got our squad mates, but you know. At least she's like, you know, she's the important girl.
She... What should I do?
Tell her. Tell her. That's a good idea. Tell people. They're an ancient warrior race. Fight for Bruhl. Recapture of Bruhl.
You will now be briefed on the operation.
The enemy is entrenched in defensive formations throughout central Bruhl and the Windmill Plaza. Squad 7 will enter from this location and cut a path into the town centre. Your objective is the occupation of the enemy's base camp. Expect the fighting along the main street to be exceptionally fierce. We also have information suggesting that they've placed snipers at various key points across town. Even if you don't see anyone in the immediate area, you may still be open to sniper fire. Be careful where you stop. Alrighty, so, enemy base captured. Valkyria welcome dies, enemy occupies Galia base camp, all our soldiers' reserves are killed, and 20 turns passed. Okay, so here we are for the battle. So what we'll do is we'll get our everyone set up. So we'll go for Misha there. Now, probably going to want to go for some people that are good in country scenarios. Don't want anyone with pollen allergies and stuff like that, because that would start messing up our ability, really. So Vice is a good option. Want Largo out there, just so we get the extra start point. Chop Largo there. So Kesre, you're going to be useful. Now, Dallas, you're going to be our engineer. And what have we got? We know you need one more assault. So I think we'll go for Hannes.
All right,
let's get started. So this is kind of attempt two.
Isara, we're taking back our homies. Squad 7, move out.
Phew. Here we are. Sorry, but I'm a little scared.
That's right. This is your first time out in battle, isn't it?
Welkin comes up with some beautiful advice here.
Kreese, combat is always a scary thing. I don't think anyone should ever forget that. I feel like getting used to the horror of war means losing hope.
Yes, sir. I understand.
So, Kreese, forget hope. Lose all hope. Don't have any hope on board.
Okay, then. Let's begin. Everybody, watch out for enemy snipers.
Beautiful advice, sir, mate. Right, so yeah, I just had to restart that because I clicked the wrong button. So we will go with Susie.
I've located the enemy.
Okay, we've got some good sightings going on here.
I've located an enemy.
We're totally exposed there.
Sniper. And I'm gonna go with this guy. I think that sniper's a bit too not a chance of hitting. Take best. Cool. Okay, good job. Susie's not exactly great for this kind of work because she is a pacifist. Put her in the long grass there, that's a good spot. She has taken a bit of a bump, but that's okay.
All troops advance.
End of current action there. I'm just gonna go back to using keyboard and mouse rather than gamepad. So we're gonna move the Shamrock forward. Deem of Shamrock. Ooh, let me be here, tools. Okay, we've got a tank too.
Please keep up formation as you flank them.
Okay, that driving's really, really bad. Forgot how wonky controls are in this game sometimes. Okay, we'll move to about there. That seems safe enough. Go to a mortar and swamp. Okay, he's taking a mortar to the face. He's not going to be too happy about that. And we'll end his turn there. So that's pretty safe. Now, there are snipers dead ahead of us, so we're going to want to take them out pretty quickly. So what we're going to do is we're going to move the Edelweiss forwards. Brum, 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 brum.
Enemy sighted.
Try to use those smoke rounds effectively.
Enemy tank dead front. Yoshinab the Hound, tank command. Relatively strong tank there. But we're going to want to take out these two first of all. Let's say about there. That should take out these two, hopefully. Swamp. That's two dead elites and one commander. So that's one dead sniper elite, so that's all good. And we can end our current action there. Now, what we're going to want to do next is probably get troops moving up a little bit. Now, we don't want to expose too much because we know there's a sniper up there. So what I'm going to do for the moment is I'm actually not going to move up. We jump to Cesare, or however you pronounce his name. And let's see if we can get a sniper shot on. Okay, we've got a scout elite. And we've got a sniper right down there, but that's a named sniper, Mash the Hunter. Got another sniper up the top there, is it? Or is it just a sniper elite? Yep, one sniper up there. We're going to need three shots to kill that guy, so he's a pretty tough target. What else we got? So we could kill this scout elite, which is probably a good idea. We're going to kill him. Let's try killing the scout elite. Let's hope we can get this shot. Cool. Okay, that's one major threat down, so that's good.
See what you get?
Good. That makes things a bit easier.
Right, so
speed is the key to mission completion. I wish you good luck.
Right, I'm trying to think the best place to put this guy. I think maybe we'll try and get over towards the Edelweiss. And then we're going to need to do another shot with him to get closer to that. But there's also a sniper to the right hand side there.
You say so.
So, well, there's another sniper up here, but sniper elite. See if we can go 2 for 2. Nice. Okay, that's two snipers down. Well, a scout and a sniper down. But one of them was an elite, so that's good news. And we know there's a trooper up there. So what we're going to do is we're just going to move to here. And that should be relatively safe for the time being, hopefully. So yeah, we should be pretty safe now to get some troops moving forward. Right, I think we're going to probably want to move our mechanic up. We've got some grass around this area, we know. So let's get
my turn, okay?
Alicia up there. this grass, and then we should be relatively safe in this spot here. I guess we could try and take a shot. Probably didn't want to do that. No, we want to lie down first. There we go. Guess we want to end the turn now. For God's sake, these controls are terrible sometimes. Alright, Edelweiss time.
Entering combat.
So, now we've got this tank here. So apparently one shot should kill this. Ah, five shots, there we go, five shots to kill, that's more like it. I was just like, wait, one shot, that's not enough, surely. Okay, so I'm going to aim for the turret, and we could smoke up, I guess, actually, that might be a good idea. We could set a smoke screen for this area, and then move our troops into a better position. Put smoke round here. If I put a smoke round here and actually press the right button. Actually, no, we won't do that just yet. We'll go for an armor piercing shot. And we miss. Of course we bloody miss. Of course we bloody miss. Oh, well, we had some good luck with the sniper.
Concentrate your fire.
Right. Our sniper should be pretty safe behind us. We move up to here.
Hostile sighted.
We've got a couple of mines to the side of us that are going to be cleared at some stage. But we should be a little bit safe behind cover, hopefully. Alright, let's end our action there. Now we've got 2 points left. Guess we could try and take another shot. But we would be out of ammo, wouldn't we? Right, so what do I want to do next? Oh, actually, seeing probably gonna want to move our sniper up a little bit more. And put that sniper on the roof there as well. So let's go and see if we can get another lucky shot in here. We can indeed. Oh, that's going to make our life so much easier right now.
See what you get?
That is a good amount of snipers dead. Okay, and we should be relatively safe just about here. Okay, let's end the turn. Right, and we've got enough action points to do one more person. It seems all the snipers are pretty much down. There's this guy here that can get a shot on our people. But that's about it. I guess we could look at moving up one of these guys forwards. Yeah, let's just do that. Try and get a few shots on this guy if we can. Not really going to be able to kill him, I don't think, but we'll give it a go. A few shots, some peppering action, that's alright, that's all we needed. So let's end the turn there and see how we go. Okay, and we have to end our phase. Yes, we'll end the phase there. Okay, let's see how this goes. Hopefully it goes somewhat well. Living horses. That tank misses first shot, that's good news. Run forward a little bit, that's not a good idea for him. sniper there, mash the hunter. Ooh, that was lucky. And that guy's dead. That's good. Alright. Okay, we've got one hit to the tank. And cool. Okay, they missed their shots. That's some good news. Okay. Right, that's the end of their turn. Okay, so you, my son, are going to want to move a bit.
Order's in order. Enemy sighted.
Fall back for now! Retreat!
Okay, so he's going to be safe there. That's a good spot for the sniper to be in, I imagine. Relatively close to the action, but not too close. Alright. Now, let's get our engineer.
Leave it to me.
What we're going to want to do.
These guys are just careless.
Is.
The town's a mess.
Pretty slowly and cautiously move up to these and disarm them, like so. That's those two disarmed. And we're going to want another section on this girl. So let's just try and take. Is there anyone that we can take a pot shot at? Probably not. Anything we can do there.
Check for snipers firing from the buildings.
And we'll end the turn there for her. And I'm gonna move forward and get those two mines.
Right away.
Make sure not to blow ourselves up. Disarm. And disarm this one. Make sure not to blow ourselves up again. Go. Okay, operation not blow ourselves up has gone very well. And what we can do now, of course, is we can use our tools. And we can go creak, 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 and do some repairs. Okay, we should hopefully be safe there.
Watch out for stray bullets.
Hopefully she's safe in that spot. It's a bit hard to tell sometimes because you're sort of like. Get our anti-tank round on board, and we're going to want to make a big shot at this person. So go for the hull and hit, please. Go, that's a good hit. I guess we could possibly move forwards because we've got those anti-tank rifles we've got to be careful of. But if we move around the corner, then at least we've got somebody protecting that corner as well. Possibly be out of the range of those anti-tank rifles too.
Watch out for their return fire.
This is horrible. What have they done to the town?
Okay, and turn there. And we'll take another step at this.
Here we go.
I'm just going to want to move a little bit further this way, but before we do that, let's just quickly get our gun on target. And get our gun on target. Kaboom. That's another shot to you. And then of course we want to make sure our vulnerable back section is not exposed, but this should be a good covering spot for us right here. Okay. And we could go for another shot, see if we can do some more damage to that tank, because we really want to take our tank out as soon as possible. Of course, it would be nice to sneak around and take it out from behind, but that's okay. Let's go for another shot. Boop to the body. That guy's not looking healthy at all. Two more shots, I think it said. So, yeah, we're getting close. It's a bit of a tough... tough ask for us. We're relatively safe in this spot. Let's end our current turn there. Now everybody's in safe spots around here, so that's all right. I guess I could move this tank up a little bit further, but this tank is really more of a infantry sort of light tank. This is not really a tank fighting tank, whereas the Ilvice is a, you know, it's got the ability for tank on tank combat, so we're going to be better off with this tank for sure. Let's hopefully get another shot on. We'll do an aimed shot. Well, of course we're going to do an aimed shot. There we go, another good hit. Alright, that's one more hit point left for that guy. So that's all good. Unfortunately, we don't have anyone that can really do anything to take advantage of that, because this guy needs two to go forwards. But what we will do is we'll move Rosie forwards, because she was in that position where she was getting shot at. And hopefully Rosie will be somewhat safe there. Although there is a sniper up there. I've got to put Rosie in a bit of a precaution, bit of an awkward spot. But we'll have to end our turn there. I wanted to make it to the grass, but obviously we didn't. So hopefully Rosie won't get shot too much. Hopefully she'll survive this round. Okay, reinforcements are here. Requesting reinforcements. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Got a few guys moving around, obviously. Here comes their retaliation with their tank.
Damage minimal.
So we should be able to take this from this tank. They shouldn't have too many shots on us. Good job, Rosie. Nice panty shot there. Ah, god damn it. That's really frustrating, because it's just like, shouldn't really be able to take shots there. Alright, Rosie gets hit. That's not good. Game advice. It's alright. As long as you don't really lose Rosie this round, we'll be okay. Please miss. Bollocks. Okay. Alright, that's not so good. We've lost Rosie. It's one thing that I would say about Valkyria Chronicles that is really frustrating when you're playing it. It's just the movement sort of point system, and the fact that you can't really redo movements. Are you sure you're going to go get them up?
Enemy sighted.
Medic.
Medic.
At least we'll be able to save
it's
these two. Where were you for Isara?
Don't worry about a thing. Enemy sighted. Enemy unit spotted. Don't allow them time to... Medic!
Like, you would think you would be pretty safe behind here and you could duck, but unfortunately you can't, and it's just a frustrating little thing sometimes.
Come on, Dallas. Don't leave me.
Okay, Dallas is safe. And we don't want to move that way because that tank will take some shots at us. And we'll just go back in the grass. Alright, and we should hopefully be safe here. So, end our action there. Right, we're going to have to take this tank out ASAP, so... No, we don't want to end our phase, we want to shoot the tank. Please hit. Okay, good. That's one tank done, and that's, I think, a command vehicle as well. No, it wasn't. Bugger. Okay. So the Eagle Vice is pretty damaged now. So we don't want to really take it into too much of a... position where it's going to take shots from anything nasty. There is a heavy anti-tank cannon there, so we're just going to want to scooch around here for a moment. And we should hopefully be somewhat safe here for the moment. Alright. Now, we're going to want to... We're gonna need Nadine to come in because we're gonna need somebody to do some repairs. Shamrock should be able to move up now at least because we've got two snipers. So we'll just have to move so we're not in range of that anti-tank gun. So Shamrock should be safe here. Machine gun's probably not going to be too great in this position. Could try an armor-piercing shot on him. Obviously not the best way of trying to kill a person, but if it hits, it hits. So, let's do it.
Fire.
No, just missed. But at least that will sort of make it a little bit harder for the enemy to push forwards. We've got two tanks sitting up there. Right, let's get our sniper into action quickly. Now, I don't want to take out that anti-tank gun pretty soon, but I'm going to try and take out their snipers first of all, of course. Actually, aim, that'd be really good. I'm going to get a headshot here. Boom, headshot. Good, good. Ezri's doing a really good job at the moment, that's always nice.
See what you get? Man down, everybody be careful.
We could try and move forwards possibly. Yeah, I guess that works. Jump back to him.
You say so.
Because we're going to want to do another shot on this one. So, if we could take out this anti-tank gunner, that would be really good. We're going to need a few shots to do that, because that's why we've got armour. We've got this guy here. He's also got protection at the moment. It's not great, is it? See here. We can see an anti-tank gun. Can't really see much else. Okay, we'll just take a shot at the anti-tank gun. Hopefully we'll do some damage to him just for some future things. That's alright, it's not the best, but that will do. And then we'll move you to the relative safety of here. Okay, so he's safe. Okay, so we've got three more points to do. So we might as well get Largo, get Hannes moving up. Crouch there. should hopefully be okay from that sniper, although, again, it says it can hit us, and it's just like, there's no way that guy could hit you from that position. Alright, let's just end there. Hopefully we'll be okay there for the time being.
Just watch this.
And we could slowly move the Largo up as well, I guess. Trooper Elite and I think the anti-tank gun from this point. Need to make another move. So I'm going to need to move Largo a little bit further up.